Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, up next we have the return of a title action with a showdown for the vacant Novice Cruiserweight Championship between challengers Jake Angelo Baker and Emmanuel King Doku. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and welcome our first challenger to the arena in the blue corner, Jake Angelo Baker. And now we welcome his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. Please show your appreciation and welcome Emmanuel King Doku. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, introducing then our first challenger, standing here in the blue corner, representing the Gauntlet's Boxing Gym. Please show your appreciation and welcome, Jake Angelo Baker. And introducing your second challenger, standing across the ring in the red corner, representing the Renegade Gym, make some noise for Emmanuel King Doku. Ladies and gentlemen, this Novice Cruiserweight title showdown is four rounds of action. Plenary referee in charge of the action, Mr. Wayne Alexander.
Here we go then, four rounds of boxing to decide the vacant Novice Cruiserweight title home. At least on a temporary basis, we have Jake Baker coming out of the blue corner. He's a local lad from Epsom, from the Gauntlet's Boxing Club, 26 years of age, up against Emmanuel Doku. He is from Nebworth, which is Stevenage Way, from the Renegade Gym, six fights under his belt. Both lads making their Quest Boxing League debut this evening, naturally. Now, apparently, Doku likes to throw big wide hooks like that. And Jake Baker was stung by that shot.
Yeah, they come straight out, met in the middle of the ring. And both straight into throwing big shots. Like you mentioned there, Doku likes to throw these big wild hooks. And when we say wild hooks, you tend to think that they should be easy to avoid, but it's not
always the way.
You can't always see them coming.
No,
they
you
come
can't.
From awkward angles.
Yeah, just like that.
Just like that as well.
Very unorthodox.
Yeah, very. It's almost like a claw. His arm went up and it sort of slacked down on him.
Yeah, it's the way a tiger would attack you, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, Jake Baker opted to take the back foot. You can see he's looking to throw those big shots as well.
Yeah.
Neither fighter is out there trying to outbox the other one.
No, that's it's all on one punch now, isn't it?
Yeah, they're out there trying to land that big shot. Baker on the back foot. He looks pretty tired. He's got a good good guard, but he needs to be aware that those shots are coming over his guard.
Yeah.
So he needs to dip his knees a little bit, raise his guard up a bit, and just take the edge off those shots.
Very good point.
Doku's not doing much other than looking for those big shots, as we just see there. He's happy just to sit out, wait, and then throw a shot when the opportunity comes.
Yeah, it's an interesting conundrum here for Baker, because you know, if he goes forward, he'll get hit. If he goes backwards, he'll get chased and hit. It's a funny one, isn't it?
Yeah, but if he uses his jab and lengthens his jab, that's all he needs to do to not get hit, because the jab's always going to be longer than one of those hooks.
That's a fact.
He's got a slight height advantage, which usually translates into a reach advantage.
But can I say, Dan, it's about the quality of the left hand.
Exactly, yes. Yeah, that jab, it needs to be a nice,
it's got to be spot
jab.
On, isn't it?
And he's got to come forward with it and then get back out again and not be there to be hit. He could make this not an easy fight. Doku's not the sort of fighter you have an easy fight against. But he can make this a lot more simple than he's currently doing.
Yeah, good point.
Doku's the round for me.
Yeah. Right, Jake Baker, 26, as I say, an excellent boy. Only one previous bout under his record, whereas there's been six fights under the record of Emmanuel Doku.
I find it quite hard to believe that Jake Baker's only had one fight. Well, he boxes really well, I know.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what I'm saying, but if that's true, it's a testament to the fact.
Well, if he's had only one fight, I saw it.
Yeah.
In fact, I saw all four of them. Anyway, no, I'm only joking. Right, so Jake Baker then looking to impose himself on this, really. And as Dan and I have both established, you know, you've got to be very, very smart with that left hand to avoid the follow-up, which is, of course, a big bang right hand from Doku.
Yeah, at present, I mean, apart from the two jabs you just threw there, what Jake Baker looks like he's trying to do is throw the jab to set up the right hand.
Yeah, but that's a mistake.
Doesn't need to do that, because he's going to put himself in a position where if Doku does throw one of those wild shots over the top,
he
catches
there.
You on the end of the chin.
That's right.
It does damage.
And he's stuck there as well, isn't he? There's nowhere he can go. If he's, you know, nice, right?
That's a lot better there. That's what he needs to do. Draw those punches from Doku.
But speed is the essence, isn't it?
He has to time it right. He needs to draw those punches, step back out of the way. If he doesn't get caught, come back in with something, because the way Doku throws those punches, it leaves him vulnerable for a counter-punch.
Mm. Good point.
This is a lot better from Jake Baker.
It is. This is very smart, sensible boxing.
And this is what I was saying, even after that first round, I find it hard to believe he's only had one fight. This is very mature.
Yeah,
boxing.
It is a mature attitude, isn't it? Yeah. And he's only 26.
26 is in great shape. Cruiserweight, he obviously fits the weight really well. 6'1". If he can show this level of maturity and experience after just one fight,
yes,
then he's going to be an exciting one to watch going forward.
Well, he just almost caught Doku again there with the shot.
Yeah, Doku's always going to be dangerous, but if Jake Baker sticks to what he's doing here and being effective with it, he's going to be. Like I said, you ain't going to have an easy fight against Doku. It's going to be a simple fight.
Yes, he's quite right. Well, I tell you what, that's a Baker round.
Yeah, that's quite easy to score that round for me.
Yeah, so just reminding, this is for a vacant novice cruiserweight title. It is a four-round contest. We've had two, one apiece, for us anyway. And it's ironic, isn't it? Do you remember earlier the decision where you said, I'm not disappointed?
Yeah, wasn't shocked.
Yeah, well, we weren't shocked by that.
Yeah.
But it's ironic, isn't it, how ordinarily we'd be furious. But we weren't, neither of us were.
No, I think, again, it's the...
We didn't agree with it.
No.
But neither of us were furious.
No, and it was... The fact was, in that fight, you could see where the judges were coming from.
And we're still talking about it. Right, round three, halfway point. So, just reminding once again, Jake Baker in the black and red in action here against Emmanuel Doku. And well, Doku there, as you can see, tearing down the gap between them. But will he get anything out of it? A bit wild, wasn't it?
It was very wild. I was just going to ask you what you think that Doku needs to do to get back into this fight.
Well, I think he just saw.
I think exactly that. I was just going to say. He's answered the question for me. But he needs to be more aggressive. Yeah. He needs to impose himself.
But now there's an alarm bell gone off in the head of Jake Baker, and I think he's anticipating that, and he's going to bang out a right hand at the same time. And I think it'll make a difference.
Yeah.
Let's just have a look. Or maybe not.
But that's what we said about it. He's using that jab to set up the right hand. It's probably not the right thing to do. He needs to keep Doku off of him.
Yeah. Left hand and feet.
And use the range to his advantage.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, it's ironic, isn't it, Dan? You know, we are very benevolent about this.
I think Baker's in trouble.
Yeah.
I don't think he's quite recovered from that earlier shot that he took. His legs look a little bit unsteady.
But they're scruffy punches, aren't they, from Doku?
Yeah, Doku, if he measured what he was doing now, he'd be a lot more effective. He's swinging. Yeah. Just throwing the shots out there. Baker taking an 8 count. Baker looks visibly tired after that.
He does, yes.
And I don't think that's the end of what Doku's got to throw in.
No. Although, having said that, Doku's very tired as well.
Yeah, they've
punched each other's hands.
He put a lot of effort into that exchange.
Yeah.
And it's whether Baker can stay composed, get back to his jab and do the simple stuff, using a lot less energy, or whether Doku's got the energy to continue that onslaught.
Quite right. Oh well, first and third to Mr. Emmanuel Doku. Second round, in our opinion anyway, or my opinion, Jake Baker. We've got 2 minutes left to go in this particular contest. And, you know, Dan, we've seen it tonight. You know, almost anything could happen.
Yeah, exactly that. I mean, I think on my card, Jake Baker's got an uphill struggle to win.
Yeah, I agree. I totally agree with you. He's a round behind and he's just one for a draw. But then again, you just don't know what's going to happen.
No, and we've seen it throughout the fight that Jake Baker has got the power to trouble Doku.
Yes.
In that first round, they both exchanged punches and they were both visibly affected by the punches.
Yeah. Baker's been hurt more. Definitely. In the last couple of rounds.
And it's those awkward shots, those awkward angles those shots come from. Doku. You don't see them coming, and the ones that you don't see coming are the ones that do the damage.
Exactly, yeah. They're the ones that knock you out.
I think Baker's doing the right thing here. I think he needs to take his time. Maybe his final. But for me, he needs to land something effective. He needs to land something that's going to do damage, because I've got him, I'll give the last round a 10-8 round because of the 8 count. And for me, it's unwinnable for him unless he gets a 10-8 count, 10-8 count in this, 10-8
well,
round this round.
I still hold out hopes for him that, you know, he can get a draw if he wins this round.
Yeah.
But, you know, that's not necessarily the truth. He'd like to think it is.
Yeah, they're both visibly tired. The action has really taken a lull with this round, and I'm not surprising. The last round was all action.
Hectic, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Well, the round's shots. Gone now. And that's all it took in a round where no one has scored anything. That's all it takes.
Yeah, those two. And again, the awkward angles they come from. I don't think Jake Baker's seeing them coming. It's really tough to defend against those sort of shots.
And again, game over here, sadly, for Jake Baker.
Yeah, I think he's just trying to see the round out. He's trying to get through the fight. He's going to be very happy to hear that final bell. He was visibly hurt in the last round. He got his way through that round. He's done himself proud to get through that fight, really. He's off his punches, were clearly affecting him.
Yeah. Yes, it's an unfortunate ending there for Jake Baker, but the right tactics were employed. And tonight's a lot of what we said tonight have been about tactics. And, you know, I think Emmanuel Doku, tactically, was fine.
Yeah, the tactics and implementing those tactics as well. That's what's been a difference tonight. Obviously, Jake Baker, I think his tactics were right. I think he came out and he tried boxing long. But those awkward long-range,
hard-to-stop
punches from Doku, they're really hard to defend against because you just don't find sparring like that.
Sure. Well, I've got it 39-37. I know that they won't read out the score, but boys, if it helps, 39-37.
I've got 39-36 to go back the 8 count.
Fair enough.
The 10-8 round.
Of course, yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, after 4 rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecards with the unanimous decision and new novice cruiserweight champion in the QBL in the red corner.
So Emmanuel Doku is the new novice cruiserweight champion.
Doku.
There to Emmanuel, and bad luck to Jake Baker. But you can see this one happening again, couldn't you?
Yeah, definitely. Jake Baker, he's going to have a point to prove after that one because I think he could have done a lot better than that. I was really impressed with him. He boxed really well, and like I said from the off, doesn't look like a fight that's only had one fight. I think there's more haven't heard about.
Yeah, you'd hope he'd had more.
Yeah, he's a good boxer. Very good boxer. Very measured.
And he's a tough guy too.
Yeah, and it's just the awkwardness and the unorthodox style of Doku that had the beating of him there. Yeah. On another night, could have been a different story.